Now, before we start off the video, if you guys do enjoy it, make sure you hit that like button, subscribe, and turn on the notification bell so you know when your boy uploads another dope video just like this one. I'm constantly making awesome videos just like this, and I already know you guys are gonna ask me down in the comments below. If you guys are wondering what the intro song is, it is BBO by Migos. Once again, the letter is B, B, and the letter O by Migos. AP on me, iced out, tennis chains, iced out. Whole one is round my neck, looking like a lighthouse. Slug, nigga, pipe down, chopper, make it pipe down. Running man, catch me if you can. Yo, what is up, guys? It's your main man, Kodak Stan. Today, we are here with another YouTube video, and today we're checking out an upcoming One Piece game that's actually looking really clean. All right, so this game, guys, I've been having my eye out on this game for so long now, and I think it's coming out soon, because I don't know. I honestly don't know, but it looks like they've made a lot of progress, and this game is called One Piece Redemption. Now, I've been having this game out for like ages, bro, since like probably 2018, maybe even late 2017. I'm not exactly sure, bro, but I've been looking out for this game for a long time. I've been wanting to do some videos on it. I did talk to the owner of the game. You know, we're working something out to see if I can get in game and show some footage pretty soon, but I decided, you know what, no biggie, I'll just make a quick informational video based on the Discord server and the sneak peeks, you know what I'm saying? Because this game has been looking clean. So this game, honestly, if I'm this is streamable, shoot, can't look at that. This game has been looking really clean, bro. I just recently looked at it for the first time, because when I first looked at it, I was like, all right, this is dope. But at the time, it was like I was focusing on other games and everything. I didn't have as much of a connection as I did with as I do now. So, like, today I was like, yo, I'm trying to get in your game and do some footage on it. He's like, yo, that's fine. So, I will be dropping the actual video of gameplay soon. But, yeah, I decided to check out some older Discord channels because I was cleaning out, or servers, not channels. Because I was cleaning out some spam Discord servers that I have, so I can have space for when I need to join new ones. Because, like, I don't know if Discord Nitro gives you, like a higher server max that you could be in, but I don't have Discord Nitro, so my server max is 100. So I decided I was cleaning out some space. So here we got something that caught my attention, which is a video of this guy literally just sitting there on his little ship with his little blades out, and it's a freaking gigantic Sea King, bro. Look how big that Sea King is, and look how it's moving. Look at those eyes, bro. I was just like, yo, that's pretty dope. So what else does this game have to offer? So we got some Bon Clay twirls into battle. I did not see that animation coming, bro, but this came out of nowhere. And we got Fighting Fish enters the ring of OPR. So what I noticed that this game did kind of give off was, like, it gave off an RPG type of vibe, you know, like kind of like a One Piece RPG type of vibe that I was feeling. And most One Piece games don't really give nowadays. I feel like nowadays One Piece games don't really feel like you're playing One Piece. It really just feels like Devil Fruit Simulator and stuff like that. You go in game, you play a game, try to find out the fastest way to get a cool Devil Fruit. You try out the Devil Fruit moves, and then you like level up your stats so that your Devil Fruit damage is super high. That's what it's been feeling like, you know what I'm saying? This game's actually been, these are a bunch of streamables I cannot look at yet. But these games have actually been, this game actually makes me feel like it's gonna be like an actual One Piece pirate game. We're actually gonna be able to go in game. Is this another streamable? Jeez, all these streamables, dude. Yeah, pick some other type of way to show off your game. Hold on, let me just open this, bro, real quick. Alright, exactly, look at that, bro. Look at that, dude. So this game actually been—it makes me feel like, you know, a game that I'll actually be able to hop in with my friends and actually go out and do crew stuff, pirate crew stuff, not just, you know, hop in game, you know, get all my friends Delfruits. We all try to find Delfruits and share Delfruits and stuff like that. We all just, you know, decide, yo, you want this Delfruit, you want this Delfruit, you know what I mean? We're actually going in game and actually trying to be a crew. So this game does have naval battles. The cannons are looking pretty clean to me, in my opinion. I think these cannons are looking pretty clean. I like how it makes you go into first person, and you pretty much, you know, your average cannon aim and everything and stuff like that. It would be cool if they had like some kind of indication that allowed you to see like where your cannon is gonna land, instead of just kind of, since the cannon doesn't shoot straight forward, it kind of like, as you see the ball, it kind of arcs. It makes like an arc or whatever. So it's kind of hard to tell exactly where your cannon's going to end up. Well, I guess it's pretty realistic, but at the same time, it's kind of hard to tell since the cannon doesn't exactly, like, aim. Like, the cannon itself doesn't actually aim up and down. It kind of just looks like it's turning a bit, as you can see here. It doesn't actually look like it's going up and down vertically. It just looks like it's moving horizontally. So it's kind of hard to tell on where exactly it's aiming. But here we got some... we got a hand, or like a cannon weapon. I forgot which one. I forgot what character uses this one. Oh yeah, this dude from Sky Island. That's who it was. The dude, he was like some ultimate warrior that they looked up to. And then here, we got some weapons that they showing off. All right. Okay, so I'm assuming that they're gonna have like dual wielding or whatever, tri wielding, which. It's pretty cool. So I'm assuming that it doesn't matter what weapon you have. Like, you know, some games, they make it so that you can only, like, you know, if you want two sword style, you can get it, but it's with that specific weapon. This game, they're making it so that you can get, like, you know, dual wielding with different weapons and stuff like that, and you can equip different weapons to different hands, which is something I remember a while back. I was like, yo, OPBA needs to do this. Well, it looks like this game is actually doing it. So let's look at this streamable right here, and look at that, bro. Look how clean that is, dude. Look how clean that is. It gives you a whole raining animation where it's giving you like droplets on your screen. So this game is gonna have a weather system, which makes me even more hyped. It is gonna be racist, as you can see here. There's a fishman. It makes me hyped the fact that this game is gonna have a weather system, because like I said, it's gonna give it that One Piece feel where you're out at sea with your crew, and then boom, a gigantic storm comes out of nowhere. You're on your ship, you're trying to survive, but your waves coming up all over the place, and you're trying not to die. So look at this streamboat real quick. So I guess the other one was just rain, but I'm assuming that this one's like an actual thunderstorm, since it's like dark and stuff. You know, it's not just like rainy, it's actually like dark outside. I'm assuming there's big gray clouds above you. That's the reason why it's that dark. And it says in a few minutes. All right, so now we got a CP. I guess people are playing poker or whatever. Who wants to play a children card game? Go fish. That's actually funny. So it looks like there will be character customization in this game, because these are obviously not like Roblox faces or hairstyles. So there will be some type of character customization. Once again, appealing to that RPG type feeling. You go in game, customize your character. You know, you check stuff out. I'm gonna actually look at some of these these streamables. I want to see more of them since I open up a few. So, oh, look at that. So I feel like this might be a boss. This is like a cutscene for a boss. Yo, look at that, bro. Look at this cutscene, dude. Look at this cutscene. So I'm assuming that there are gonna be different bosses that you are able to take on. I'm assuming that I haven't confirmed it yet. I still gotta check in and stuff like that with Kyle. But it does seem like there's gonna be actual bosses that you can take on, because that cutscene, you know, that's the only explanation for why you would have a boss. And then you got the cyborg, you know, your cyborg abilities. Oh my gosh. Alright, so I'm not sure if cyborg is gonna be like a type of, I don't know what you would call it, because cyborg is like kinda like in the middle between race and fighting style, since, you know, cyborg is exactly a race. You aren't born as a cyborg, you're made into a cyborg. But at the same time, it's not exactly a fighting style. It's not just like something that you just pick up or whatever. It's something that you have to build into your, like, it's like a change to your actual body. You know, you're altering your body. So I'm not sure if it's I'm assuming that you would actually put it as a fighting, not even a fighting style, as a race. Because, you know, I guess Frankie could learn Blackleg style if he wanted to, but at the same time, Frankie isn't exactly human, but, like, I feel like it's, like, a race that kind of determines your fighting style, if that makes sense. Yeah, that's basically what Cyborg is. It's kind of like a race or whatever, or a class that would determine your fighting style. So, let's see what else we got over here. Anything that I did skip over that I probably would want to look at. We saw all that stuff. And so he said, all right, sneak peek. So this is a fishman jujutsu. All right, so this is a fishman ability that that was shown in the anime. Oh, that's only, you can only look at that by the streamable. That's crazy. So let's look at this right here. All right, so that's some fishman karate. That's pretty dope. That's pretty dope. Look at that fishman karate, dude. Oh my gosh. All right, so you got that. And then we got over here. Let's see, we got some new addition to the weapon collection, Kid Pirate's Killer Scythe. All right, okay, let's look at this. All right, so those are some nice animations. So this game, they're not just gonna have your basic average swords and stuff like that, where you just do the same old sword animations. You're gonna have different types of weapons, different animations for different stuff. And you gotta have this gigantic Sea King, bro. That Sea King is no joke. That Sea King is no joke. But yeah, so this game is looking pretty clean. I'm really excited to get in the little server or whatever. Oh snap, you just punch a cow. So I'm assuming that this is like a mob or something that you can fight. I don't know. Oh my gosh, she's boxing a cow. She's boxing a cow. That's crazy. But yeah, so I'm pretty excited for this game. This game is looking pretty dope. I can't wait to actually get in and record some footage to show you guys. If you guys are hyped for this game, make sure you show that love by hitting that subscribe button down below. Leave in the comments what you want to see and what you hope to see in this game that's coming out. Who knows? I don't know. I want to say soon, but honestly, I can't say soon because I'm not the developer. I'm not going to tell you guys or pretend like I do know when this game is coming out. But so let me know what you guys hope to see in this game. Also, if you guys did enjoy the video, don't forget to hit the subscribe button and the notification bell. So you know when your boy uploads another dope video just like this one. Like I said, I will be showing some actual in-game footage once I get access to the server. They recently just added me to the list. But with that being said, until next time, guys, we are out.